Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well today. Today's video is going to be an eye look, a simple eye look using the Black Heart Interstellar Eyeshadow Collection. And I did this look the other day, just thought I would mess around with this palette, and I thought the eye look looks pretty decent, so I thought I would recreate it for you guys today. And we're just going to be using two eyeshadows, and we're going to go ahead and get started. I am going to apply primer for this, though, because primer is very important. It's going to be the Urban Decay Primer Potion in Original. Oh, if I don't make it slip, let me get my little towel. I like using a towel just on my lap so that way any fallout or any mess ups I can easily wipe off. And I have my little mirror right here. If you're asking, what the heck is she looking at? It's the little mirror. I thought I would do it this way and see how this works out. So I'm just applying the potion primer like this, making sure it's everywhere. All right, and then we're gonna get started. So I'm going to take this is what the palette looks like on the inside, by the way. I'm going to take Nebula right here. And I'm going to take my crease brush from Moda Pro. It is the BMX 430 crease brush. And I am just going to dip it in there. This eyeshadow palette does take some build up. The eyeshadows in here, well, the two that I've used, I noticed need some build up to them, so that's not too big of a problem. The fallout, though, for the eyeshadow isn't that much. I'm like patting it on and nothing's coming out. So then I'm just gonna put it on my crease if I manage to do it correctly. I like to close my eyes and then apply the eyeshadow on the crease that way, and then I open it up. I have hooded eyes, so it's a little harder for me to do creases in some certain looks. I know there are plenty of tutorials for hooded eyes and things, and I guess I could base myself off of those, but I just haven't really looked at those. And then it's just going to be all over the crease. There's going to be a little bit on top. We're not going to worry about that necessarily because we're going to cover that up eventually. Take it, my brush. Dip it back in there and do the same thing with the other eye. And we're gonna go just back and forth, back and forth. I'm gonna need to put this on a little more. On each eye, like I said, build up. It's all about the build up here. So just making sure I have enough color in both. And if you take it too far up, that's totally fine. I do that all the time. I just take like a makeup remover wipe or some makeup remover that I have here, and then I just wipe off any thing that I think might be too excessive or goes up a little too high, higher than what I want it to be. So this is what it currently looks like. And then I'm going to be using Asteroid for the full eye look. I like to use my finger for it. It applies better if I use my finger because this is what it looks like pigmentation wise. Using it with a brush just doesn't work, but I find that to be the case with anything that has a little more shimmer in it. For whatever reason, brushes just don't work. And then I'm just gonna start tapping it in and working with it. It is gonna be some buildup. The blue one isn't as difficult to build up as the purple one is. Oh, hello, Smushy Poo. Alex just walked right by the door. So As you can see, I don't know if you guys can really notice, but there's a blend of the purple, or the more pinky one, I guess, since it's not really super purple, and the blue, which I like. It just gives it something extra to it. I wish I had thought of putting some music on for you guys, so you're not listening to silence and dead air. But it is what it is. Oh, I've started to get some at the bottom. Totally fine. Totally fine. And this is what it's looking like. Progression. Do the same thing on the other eye. Just. I had a little extra time today, so I thought I would go ahead and film this look for you guys and try to actually put somewhat of a tutorial up on my channel as well. So this is accomplishing two things, but I thought this would be a nice simple one to start off with. I'm not an expert by any means. By any means. In terms of makeup and application and doing all of that blending and crease work and, putting five to, however many eyeshadows. Not saying that that's a bad thing. There are some really talented people out there, but I'm just not there. So, I'll just do what I think I'm decent at. So. It's a little bit more on this side. Like I said, and I mentioned already twice, probably. Lots of buildup. Lots of buildup. Move back in with Nebula really, really quick so some of it just still stays on there. It doesn't disappear. In case I took it way too far up. I do like that this has barely any fallout though. Alright, as you can see, I have some right here and right here underneath. I don't really like that, so I'm going to take it away with a towelette. I am using the Meyer brand facial cleansing towelettes, in case anyone is interested. Which, you'd think really drug, not drugstore, wow, grocery store makeup wipes, but they're decent. They are decent, in my opinion. And they are not that expensive. Don't remember the actual price. But then again, I bought them on a sale. It was like, buy one, get one 50% off, or buy two, get them for. But it has 60 towelettes, which I think is great. Because normally, others have about 30 makeup wipes in them, and this one has 60, so it's gonna last me a while. Removing some that I think might be a little too far up for me. I know that that's what some people do, but for me that's just a little too much. All right, so that is the full look, as you guys can see, and I'm just gonna finish up with some eyeliner and mascara, and then we will be good to go for the day. I'm going to be using the Iko London Skinny Liquid Eyeliner in black. And if you guys have seen my. Oh, when did I do this? When did I do this? I feel like I did another eye look. Oh, when I did my BoxyCharm for the ColourPop one. Because I was also just working, doing a full face kind of with that. And oh, wrong eye. I like to take my time with the eyeliner. Especially since I blink a lot when I apply it, so Ah! Almost out of my eye. Oh wow, I noticed I wasn't even on camera for that good minute. Moves on from the bottom. I never understand how eyeshadow just spreads to your face. Like, how in the world does it go from being on your eye to your cheeks? How? Especially when you're trying to wipe it off. Like, are you serious? The point is to wipe it off, not spread it around. Definitely should have had some music playing for you guys. Or something. But it is what it is. Right, I think just a little more right here. And that should be good to go. A little cleanup with that as well. Use my handy dandy makeup wipe. Then I'm going to use Beauty Concepts Volumizing Mascara. I'm just going to apply it on the lashes and hopefully not poke myself. As much as I didn't like their lip glosses and some of their other items from Beauty Concepts, the mascara is pretty good in my opinion. The only thing is, I don't know if it's the eyeliner or the mascara. I feel like it might be both. By the afternoon, it's all kind of black underneath my eyes. So that's maybe my only con with this, but other than that, I think it's pretty good. There's no clumpiness to it. I don't know if you guys could see that there was no clumpiness. That was the point of that. Unless you guys were probably thinking, what is she doing? No, I was just trying to show you that there's no like clumpiness. I know some other mascaras are clumpy, and this one I don't feel is clumpy or super clumpy or anything like that. But that's pretty much the eye look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.